Oh my goodness, no. Viewers who view other channels know what's wrong with this. Hi, welcome back to PC Biller. I'm Jason. We have so many great submissions this month for Boost My Build. That's right, this is a series where you submit your PC part picker list and we boost up your build in terms of performance and price. We've got crazy things this month, including exploding power supplies, Alder Lake builds versus Ryzen builds for the very first time, and a lot of other really, really fun stuff. Of course, that's what we do here. We get you the best price to performance in your PC. If you get value in the video, give it a like. It really makes a big difference to the channel. And of course, subscribe and click that bell icon. That way you get notified when we release new content. With that, let's jump into it. All right, let's go over to Jiva. Jiva is from India. Awesome. This is their very first PC build. Hey, congratulations. They're looking for budget high FPS 1080p gaming. Good news is we can probably build that right now. They want to play Valorant. Valorant will run on a toaster. Good news. $1,300 to $1,400 budget. They got a GTX 1660, not even a Super Ti. Ouch. For $505. I want to cry. But hey, you got the card. We're going to use it. I know the market in India is really tough right now. Their budget includes that GPU, so we're going to take that out. They're not sure about the motherboard. They don't need high-end audio because they use a digital connection. They don't necessarily like RGB. They need some help. So let's take a look at their build. They've got a Ryzen 5 5600X. Okay, I like where we're starting with this. Don't necessarily need that power for a 1660. I went with the MSI B550A Pro. That's absolutely fine. G-Skill Ripjaw. 16GB DDR4 3200 CL16, absolutely all you need for that level of GPU. And I'm starting to see some problems now. Okay, problem number one is this Western Digital Blue 500GB drive. Why, Jason? It's an M.2. Yes, but it's a SATA M.2. This is a really sneaky one. This actually catches a lot of people, so completely understandable for a first timer. The second thing I see is I'm somewhat familiar with this case, and I know why you like this case, because it looks super cool, but it's terrible. It is a terrible airflow case. Again, looks super cool. If Gigabyte had just done a good job with this case and actually given it some airflow, this would be a cool case. But unfortunately, this is basically a microwave oven for your PC. We don't want that. Oh my goodness, no. Viewers who view other channels know what's wrong with this. Stop the video right now. Say in the comments what's wrong with this right now. That's right, this is an exploding power supply. Now, of course, if you're a first-time builder, of course you're going to fall for things like this. You're just not going to know enough, right? That's why you come here. I'm glad you came to us. We're going to stop your PC from exploding and being microwaved. So we're going to get rid of this power supply because it's terrible. And then you went with a 1080p monitor that I'm really not familiar with, the Gigabyte G24F and Corsair wired keyboard. I guess that's all part of our budget. You're already over budget, by the way. You're at $1,463 before I even start doing anything. I know I've got to find $63 in this thing. So let's take a breath. Okay, how do we build you a PC that gets you 1080p gaming on a budget, doesn't explode, and doesn't microwave the components? Here we go. Okay, so I called this the non-exploding with airflow and NVMe build. I went ahead and stuck with the Ryzen 5 5600X. I know the 3600 is not really available. You could go with an Intel platform. Just know that. You could go with like an i5 11400, 10400F. That would maybe save you some money here. I don't know what those parts go for in India right now, but it's an option with a B560 motherboard. So that's one thing to consider. I decided to stick with your direction, which is go Ryzen 5600X. Nothing wrong with your motherboard, B550A Pro. I know you ended up buying it for an inflated price. That's just the market in India. I get that. Your memory's great, but the first thing we fixed is the Western Digital Blue SN550. That's the drive we're going to go with. This is an actual NVMe drive. How do I know that? Because you see this notch right here? There's only one of them. On the SATA drives, there's a second notch at the top here. That's how you know it's a SATA drive, and it's not going to run any faster than a regular 2.5-inch SATA with a cable. Just because it plugs in the M.2 doesn't matter. It's the protocol itself. I know this drive is widely available, particularly in India, so this is a drive you should be able to get. We want 500 gigabytes. You know, look, consider a terabyte if it's within the budget. We just came in under your $1,400, by the way. We're at $1,374.80 for those who want to know. Graphics card's great. The case was a real problem. I actually had a hard time finding something that I thought would be available in India. So I did go through and using a conversion from rupees to US dollars, I did find on Amazon India, this it's Chiptronics ZX1000. RGB. Now, this is it's kind of very similar aesthetic to the case you had, kind of that blocky black, really angular case, only this one actually has fans associated with it. It's got mesh. It's got side mesh as well. This is going to be a really, from what I can tell, a really good airflow case. Has really high ratings there. I'm not familiar with this brand. Again, I think it's a brand that doesn't come into the U.S., but for 3,299 rupees, which I believe is like $43, it's actually going to be cheaper than the case that you wanted to get, and it's going to have airflow, come with three included fans. If you don't like the RGB, you can just turn that off. Remember, you can just turn the RGB off. You don't have to have it on. So don't think that you have to have that on at all. Thinking about the kind of power supplies, we want to get you one that's not going to explode. And I don't know the Indian market that well, but I'm sure that you can find either a Corsair or an EVGA power supply, something like the CX650M. This is a semi-modular power supply, 650 watts. You don't need 650 watts. Frankly, you could get away with 450 watts, I think, in this build. But this one right now happens to be on sale in the US, so it just popped to the top. But that's the kind of power supply you're looking for. And of course, into that I threw an extra fan because your case needed one more fan. But overall, for $1,400 USD, here's a build that's not going to explode. It's not going to microwave your components, and you're going to get actual NVMe SSD speeds instead of SATA speeds for a cheaper price. Danger Man, I love the name, awesome. They've got a $1,500 budget. Ooh, hopefully that does not include the graphics card. They got three problems. They're not sure about their case. They're not sure about the motherboard, and they want to game it 1440p, 120 FPS or more if it's possible. Let's see what you've got. Wow, okay, $1,500 is not going to get this done. I'll tell you that right off the bat. But let's, number one, you've got the very first Alder Lake build on Boost My Build. So congratulations there. We've got an Intel i7-12700K. This is not a CPU you get if you're on a budget, by the way. So, look, great gaming performance. Early adopter problems, though. I'm getting a lot of messages about people having memory issues with certain types of memory kits. It's like Ryzen 1000 all over again, basically. Then we've got the Corsair, a 360mm all-in-one liquid cooler. It's a very, very good cooler. We've got the ASUS Tough Gaming Z690 Plus Wi-Fi. I don't like the price of this board. I think this board is massively overpriced, so we'll go through that. Corsair RGB memory, it's 3600 CL18. That's fine. I would like to see CL16 probably with Alder Lake. We got a Kingston A2000 1TB drive, perfectly fine, $99. You ended up with an RTX 3080 Ti. That's why you're doing this. I get it now. RTX 3080 Ti, yes, super high-end graphics card, right? You've got the Cooler Master case, H500M. Now, this is an ATX case. This is a massive case, by the way. These are 200mm RGB fans. Now, a lot of people will compare this to the Li & Li one. However, this one you can fit, like, I think a 360mm all-in-one liquid cooler in the top, in the roof of this thing. So this is an absolutely massive case, and it's got a massive price for $210. The power supply is a problem, not because the model itself, there's anything wrong with it. This is actually a good rated model, but because it's only 750 watts. And frankly, at this wattage, because of the graphics card mostly, but also because of the i7-12700K, we're drawing 649 watts. That's our peak draw. I typically like to go 1.5 times above that. As we get up to super high wattages, though, you can reduce that safety multiplier a little bit. Otherwise, you get into really stupid levels of power you need. And then we've got the Gigabyte M27Q, which is the best budget 1440p high refresh rate gaming monitor out there. But remember, it's a budget monitor, and this is like a super premium build. I feel like this build is a little upside down in terms of we're putting power into the wrong places. Yes, we want to maximize that 3080 Ti, but we want to maximize it for the visuals, not just for how many frames it's going to pump out, but for our overall gaming experience and gaming benefit. Not to mention, we are $1,637. We are $137 over your budget. So I already have to find $137 in this budget. So let's see what we can do with this. Okay, let's take a look at what I did. This was actually a real struggle because I wanted us to get the Samsung Odyssey G7. Right now, it's still on special, $500 for 27-inch. This is the best 1440p gaming monitor, bar none. And frankly, in my opinion, it's still the best gaming monitor, period. 240 hertz refresh rate. Everybody knows this monitor by now. It's amazing. And I would love to see us with an RTX 3080 Ti have that monitor instead of the Gigabyte M27Q, if we can. So what did I do? I reduced us down to the 12600K. We're still $25 over budget. Remember, I had to find $163 because you were already so far over budget. But there's no reason to get the 12700K just for gaming. There's a handful of games in which it will give you a very small additional FPS boost, but those are FPS boosts that you're not even going to be able to see with any kind of realistic monitor, so why do it? I went with the ID Cooling ZoomFlow 240X ARGB cooler. This is a nice cooler. You can get the LGA 1700 socket on Amazon. When you buy the cooler, you should still be able to get it for free. I went ahead and stuck out with your motherboard because right now, most of these Z690 motherboards that I would recommend are totally sold out. And so this turns out to not be the worst option. If you can find another 10 bucks, I actually think the Tomahawk Z690 is a slightly better motherboard, probably worth the $10, but we're already over budget. I just couldn't find it in me to do it. I went with just a cheaper 3600 CL18 kit of memory, RGB kit. Now you can also get this one in black if you want it in black. It just shows you the white version. That's the T-Force Delta. It's 2x8 gigabytes. And of course, we went with a cheaper storage, just trying to whittle off every last nickel I can on this thing to get you under that budget. Western Digital Blue SN550, still on $84 right now. That's a great, great deal. You know, another way to save money is, of course, come down to 500 gigabytes, but gosh, that just feels hard. The power supply, we were able to go up to 850 watts. I really could not find any. I really wanted to get a 900, 950 watt power supply in there. This is going to be fine though. Enermax Revolution D850. This is an A tier rated PSU on the PSU cultist list. Fully modular. Fantastic unit. One I highly, highly recommend. And of course, we reduced your case. We decided not to go with as much cooling and not as much CPU power. And that allowed us to knock down the cooler to a 240 millimeter all-in-one liquid cooler. And instead of going with that stupid expensive Cooler Master case, which is essentially the same thing as the Li & Li LandCool 215, this is just a smaller version of it basically. We went with this for $100. That's a much, much better deal. And it comes with all the included fans that you're gonna need. This is one way to do it. So overall, we came out at $1,526. I will just give you a window into what this might look like with a Ryzen build instead. If we use a 5800X, because the platform is so much cheaper than Alder Lake, we actually were able to go with a 5800X here for $340. I went with a much better, one of the best all-in-one liquid coolers on the planet in the EKAIO 240. This is an RGB cooler. It's $110 though. It's more expensive. Don't necessarily need all that cooling, but why not? We went with the B550 Tomahawk for $140. If you need Wi-Fi, there are several really good Wi-Fi enabled B550 motherboards for about $10 more maybe. Memory, we actually came up to 3600 CL16. Better memory kit here. Again, we're spending more money because we got more money to spend. Same drive, same case, same power supply, and same awesome Samsung Odyssey G7 monitor for only $1,472. We actually finished this build $28 under your budget. So just something to consider when you're thinking about the best CPU for gaming. For an RTX 3080 Ti, this is actually going to get you a better overall experience because you're going to have a much better monitor, better audio on this board. Something to consider when you're taking a look at the differences between the two platforms. C13 Colin, they've got an i7-7700K 2060 build and they want to upgrade, but they're not sure what to do because they just got an RTX 3070 Ti. They want to do 144 hertz, 1440p gaming. They like Halo Infinite. They like Battlefield 2042. Those are the kinds of games they want to play. So basically higher end shooters. Their max budget is $2,500. Not sure what CPU and motherboard to pair. They like RGB and they want good storage for all their stuff. So let's check out what they've got here. Okay, so it looks like they haven't identified a CPU and a motherboard yet. So what we have is a Fantex Glacier. That's a 240 all-in-one liquid cooler. It's $170, a little more on the expensive side. They've got 32 gigs of DDR4, 3600 CL16 memory. That's pretty good memory. That's maybe a little bit more than I'd like to pay, but that is RGB as well. They've got a 4 terabyte traditional hard drive. They've got a 2 terabyte Samsung 970 Evo. Ooh, that's a kind of an expensive drive right now. Given that PCIe Gen 4 drives have gotten lower. They've got their RTX 3070 Ti that they got for $600. Hey, great job there. Awesome. They've got a Fantex Eclipse P360A, a nice airflow case. They've already bought, looks like, the Be Quiet Pure Power 11 750 watt PSU. They got a 3-pack of fans for that, even though you've got an AIO. Okay, we'll get into that. Don't worry. And then I think this is a great value. They've got the Western Digital Black 1 terabyte SN750 SE NVMe drive, and it comes with a copy of Battlefield 2042. Now, if you don't care about Battlefield 2042 or you hate it or whatever, this is not a good value. But if you want to play that game, it is a pretty good value at $150 because you get the game with it and you get the drive. So overall, you're getting a really good drive for about, you know, $89. You're getting about a $10 discount by bundling them together. Okay, so let's talk about what CPU we're going to put on this platform. Again, you've got an RTX 3070 Ti. Now, we're in a really weird space right now because Alder Lake just launched, but it's got a lot of early adopter bugs. And I anticipated that, but I've kind of forgotten that the rest of the community didn't. You know, the last time we had an early adopter platform was Ryzen back in, 2017. And since then, we've kind of been spoiled in that we just expect to buy something day one release, plug it all in, and other than, you know, some minor compatibility issues, have things just absolutely work. But that has not been the case with a lot of Alder Lake systems. I'm continually getting messages that, you know, XMP profiles aren't working. Certain types of memory are just not, I don't want to say bricking, but they're just not functioning with some of these motherboards. Some of the motherboards are having BIOS update issues, and the platform as a whole has needed a lot of BIOS updates for the Z690 motherboards to fix a lot of bugs. You know, SSDs not showing up, things of that nature. So if you're cool with buying into an early adopter platform, I still think Alder Lake is, you know, is a very interesting bet right now. But if you're not cool with that, you know, then I would buy a more mature platform. And with the RTX 3070, what we're looking at here is we're looking at either Intel, I think 11th gen, or Ryzen 5000. And I think Ryzen 5000 still makes a lot of sense, especially when you're talking about this level of performance, where you will see a difference between, say, like an 11600K, an Intel i5-11600K, and a Ryzen, you know, 56 or 5800X. Now, obviously, the Intel platform is going to cost less right now. That's one advantage of it. So if you want to spend less, that's fine. But if you still want to spend just a little bit more and continue to increase performance, I would look at doing a Ryzen build instead. So let's look at a similarly spec'd Ryzen build. Now, you could do this with the Ryzen 5800X as well. I just decided to go with the 5600X because doesn't really seem like we need that increased level of performance. We went with the Ryzen 5600X. I went with the Arctic Liquid Freezer 2 RGB cooler. This is one of the top performing RGB coolers or liquid AIO coolers, period. And it's significantly cheaper than the Fantex one. Good, the Fantex is fine, but I just can't see spending an extra $60 on it. And this one's got some cool RGB to go with it. Now, you wanted Wi-Fi on your motherboard, so we went with the ASUS ROG Strix B550F Gaming. This really fantastic motherboard. In fact, the PC I'm using here has this exact same motherboard. $170. We stuck with your memory kit just because you can save $10 or $15 by going with a slightly cheaper RGB memory kit, but you seem to like this one, so we're going to stick with it. Overall, though, with the storage, I decided to save a little bit of money by going with the ADATA XPG SX8200 Pro. This is a 2 terabyte, but it's only $200 right now. So this is a drive that's great prosumer level drive. I'm guessing you want to boot to this Western Digital Black, and you're buying it because it's a good deal with the with Battlefield 2042, and maybe you don't own it yet. So I went ahead and stuck that out. And then, you know, listen, you don't need a 3-pack of fans. Why is that? Well, let's take a look at your case, right? So we've got 2 fans here in front that it comes with. These are, I believe, 140 millimeter. This can be, I think, either 120 or 140. And this is where your AIO is going to go up here. So if you got your AIO and it's got a couple of fans here, how many more fans do you really need? You just need one for the rear exhaust. So you don't need to buy a 3-pack. So it's just one of those things where rather than spending a whole ton of money by accident buying a 3-pack of ARGB fans that you're never going to end up using, why not just buy one fan for $14? I don't even know why the 3-pack is $84. That's just insane pricing. Maybe it's some third-party thing on on Amazon. But overall, we're able to do this build for under $2,000. That's all inclusive, everything here. Again, you had a budget of $2,500, maybe consider going up to a 5800X. That cooler would work just fine for you. Or, of course, you could go with an Intel build. You can go with like an i5-11600K, probably save $100 or something like that. Now, it will have slightly less performance. Personally, I would go with a Ryzen system right now until they iron out the Alder Lake bugs. One thing I got to tell you I really noticed this month is the quality of the build submitted was really good, really, really good. A lot of the builds I looked at, and I'm like, I would do exactly this. But there were a couple where you were really close and it just needed a couple of tweaks. Sylvain Bernard, they wanted something for a lot of games that actually I like Horizon Zero Dawn, Battletech, MechWarriors 5, Mercenaries, a lot of games, Jedi Fallen Order. Their budget was only $1,300 and with $500 of that towards the GPU. And if we look at their overall build, I think they did a really, really good job on that. Now, they didn't put in here what they're going to spend for the GPU. I'm assuming they're going to have to get one from Newegg Shuffle. Again, RX 6600 and 6600 XTs are also options in this environment. But they went with a Ryzen 5 5600X, which is fine. I still think AMD needs to drop the price of this processor more. Rockstrix B550F, they were able to pick this up for $147 on a deal. They got a Crucial Ballistics kit, a DDR4 3600 CL16. We didn't need 3600 CL16, but you know, $80 is not a terrible buy for that. And then they're looking at the Crucial P2. They've got the deal on it for 1 terabyte, $83. They're also looking at, you know, an MX500 for $167. That's actually pretty cheap SATA storage, but you can get cheaper NVMe storage for about $159. You can actually get the Crucial P2 for $160 right now. And then they went with the Phantex Eclipse P400A. This is a good case. I think it's a little overpriced. I like the P360A here instead, but great case, $5. So I'm not going to beat you up for $5. And then we went with the EVGA B5 for $45. Overall, very, very good build. But again, what do we see? We see a couple of things here. One is that, yes, we can get better NVMe storage than we can get SATA storage right now for that price. The other thing is, I would, for $25 more, go with a budget air cooler for the 5600X, and I would replace the stock cooler. You can use the stock cooler, but you will get more performance, and it'll be quieter if you do something like, again, Hyper 212, id cooling, SE224, that style of Gamex 400, kind of Be Quiet, Slimrock 2, those kinds of coolers. And then, of course, the other thing is, remember, cases like this, they come with three great, amazing ARGB fans, but they don't come one for the rear exhaust. So definitely get one for the rear exhaust. You can get a Phantex fan if you want to match them. You can get a Phantex RGB fan that's 120 millimeters for like $13 or $14. I would probably go that route if you want to match them. But again, another really, really good build. So what did you think about those builds? Would you do things differently? And of course, remember, this is only part one of two. We have another whole Boost My Build. If you haven't gotten your feel yet, there will be another one coming in a week. In the meantime, I'm going to put the entire playlist for Boost My Build right here. You can just binge the heck out of Boost My Build. Check it out. Tell me what you would do differently. Send me some crazy comments, and I'll catch you on the next one.